Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. Today, we have a PlayStation 5. According to the customer, this thing does not read discs. Let's get it hooked up, put a disc in, confirm the problem, and then we'll tackle how we're going to fix it. Here we have the PlayStation powered on. Let's go into the menu. We have FIFA 22 test disc here, and we'll see what type of noises it makes. And you can see the icon at the top there, the little disc, just there. And we get unrecognized disc, or unreadable disc. We do have another disc here, Call of Duty Black Ops, and the disc is in good condition. You can hear it searching. And there we go, unreadable disc again. I'm 99.9% sure that this is just going to be a bad laser. We have a replacement laser right here. We will be taking out this laser sled, replacing it with this, and then we'll retest and see what the results are. Here we go with the disassembly. I'll speed run through all of this up to the point of replacing the laser sled. Here we have the customer's drive removed from the shell, all good. Here we go, we need to be careful lifting this up because the PCB is screwed to this bottom plate, and then we have some ribbon cables, so don't just prise this off thinking it will just come off. You will be pulling on ribbon cables. See them there? Okay, we have four cables plugged in. We can just gently pull them out, and then we've got the main data cable here. Next, we need to remove four screws, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then this entire top lid should come off. There we go. Here is the laser sled, and then we've got the data cable running there. Get our replacement. See, it looks exactly the same. Just so I don't get anything mixed up, just put an X on that. Okay, we have the replacement laser sled installed. If this is your first time ever doing anything like this, I would recommend not having this board tethered the way I done it, because you could rip or pull out the cable from this side. That was just me being me. We just need to put in all the perimeter screws and then we can give this a test. Top tip with these ribbon cables, don't be tempted to pull it out or wiggle it out left and right and pull. What you need to do is push this metal tab down gently and then pull. If you pull this out without releasing it, these tabs either side, although they look small and insignificant, they will break off. And when you come to put that cable in, that cable won't be centralized in that socket, and it could be further over that side or it could be further over that side. As you can see here, there are a lot of connections, and the width of one of them tabs is easily a width of a pin. So if this cable goes in and it's one pin shifted over, you could be sending voltage where it ought not to be going. You could end up in a world of problems. So always press and pull. When you're reinserting it, you don't have to press it. You can just push the cable in and you'll hear it click. Like so. We're done. Okay, at this point, the console isn't screwed back together. There are no screws in anything at the moment. But it's together enough to test, because if I've made a mistake in here, I don't want to have to undo all of these screws again. At this point, I've just got the cables connected. Everything is together enough for an initial test. Let's put a disc in the drive. After a lot of messing about and two lasers since, we've still got the same problem. It doesn't read discs. So this is the problem. Let's throw a disc in. Takes the disc. Makes the usual noises. But never actually spins up the disc and reads it. However, I put my finger here on the PCB of the drive, and all of a sudden, not only did it read FIFA 22, but it also read Black Ops. So I would suspect that the motor controller has gone faulty in it. So I've reflowed both of the joints, and now it's doing what we're witnessing now. There you go, unrecognized disc. So what I'm going to do is swap out the controller IC and see if that makes any improvement, because at the moment, since reflowing it, it's actually got slightly worse. This is the controller IC for the motors, and I believe it's this that's gone faulty, so we will swap it out from another board here. Here we are under the scope. So first things first, let's mark this one so we know it belongs to this board. So we'll just put a small X there, put a small X there on the ground plane. So now we know. Let's lift this IC off. Here is the one we're going to take. As you can see, I've put a number 2 on it. That just corresponds to the console that it's come off. So I have rebuilt the drive. This has the original laser that came with this console. We have the board in there with the new motor controller. Let's install this drive and hopefully it should work with the original laser. Again, I'm only going to put this together enough to test first of all. Let's get these plugs in. Brilliant. Let's get some cables plugged in. Okay, and let's put FIFA in. Okay, we get no grinding. I know there's a bit of a noise. The case is not correctly, so there we go. Customer's original laser in there, all it was that IC that had become faulty. So let's shut this down, get it fully assembled, and one last test. Okay, let's turn him on and see what happens. Oh, pop the disc out. Okay, we get a display, which is good. Let's turn the controller on. Sounds good. As you can hear, making all the correct sounds now. There's no clicking, no grinding. We've got a working PlayStation. So here is the laser sled. What was actually happening, as I was looking through the mech, I could see the laser moving down and it was hitting right here where the motor is, and it was going click, 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 click. And that sounded like a cog slipping, and it was quite fast and it kept doing that. So that also led me to give the daughter board a bit of a poke around and checking the connections, giving them a wiggle as a disc was in there, and yeah, it just sprang into life. Replaced the motor controller IC, and here we go. We have a working PlayStation. I hope you learned something, because I sure did. Nice successful repair, this one. If you have any issues with consoles, Xbox, PlayStation or Nintendo, give us a shout. Check down below on how to contact us. And as always, thank you for watching. Take care.